Hi there! In this episode, you will learn how to enable and use predictive code completion. Joule's task is to predict the next lines of source code. In this example shown here, the method should calculate the mean absolute deviation. Therefore, we first describe in natural language what the implementation should do. Please make sure to enable automatic triggering of predictive code completion in your ABAP development tools to leverage this feature. After the automatic triggering of predictive code completion is activated, Joule suggests a code proposal. This proposal is based on the previously written comment in natural language. At this point, the inserted code by Joule is only a proposal. By pressing the tab key on the keyboard, the code suggestion is accepted and inserted as well-formatted ABAP code. To better illustrate this functionality, we will implement an example of how to read business partner data. The aim of this method is to read the full name of a business partner based on its given ID. In order to receive predictive code completion from Joule, we describe in natural language what the ABAP code should do. To receive predictive code completion from Joule, again, the corresponding button in ABAP development tools must be active. The predictive code is displayed as ghost text within the editor. When you press the tab key on the keyboard, the ghost text is accepted and transformed into actual ABAP code. In the example shown here, you see an error. This is because the object iBusinessPartner TP3 is a wrong data source. This typically occurs when Joule does not receive enough information to generate a proper answer. Now you need to take action. Since we want to read the business partner data via a wrap object, using the Entity Manipulation Language, or EML, we include this information into our natural language statement. Now, Joule suggests ghost text again. By pressing the tab key on the keyboard, the ghost text is accepted and transformed into actual ABAP coding again. Compared to the first predictive code, which was an OpenSQL statement, we now see an EML statement. Unfortunately, the code formatting is not yet as expected. Of course, the ABAP code generated by Joule can be adjusted anytime. Not only can you format the code to your preference, but also make modifications to the EML statement. In this example here, you can add the missing response parameters failed and reported to the EML statement. In the end, after all the desired changes have been made, the method only needs to be saved and activated.